Okay, I will let him know.
What up, Rick? You good?
Hey, yeah, just got off the phone with Othello Akpem's assistant, and the big boss man wants to see you.
What about? I mean, he's not one of those super hands-on GMs, is he?
Nah, I mean, that's not really his reputation.
So...
Honestly, I don't know what this is about, man. I mean, I tried to press his assistant for some more info, but all he told me was that Coach Graves will be there, too.
Okay. Something about this feels off.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I agree.
You got any advice?
Go in there with an open mind, see what they want to talk about, and come back here and we'll talk about it.
All right. Bet.
MP! Come on in, take a seat.
What's up, MP?
Coach Graves, Mr. Akpem.
What'd I tell you about that? Othello, please.
All right, man, my bad, you got it.
So, about Shep.
Oh, boy, you too.
Now just listen, we knew the PR hit we'd take for picking you over him, but that's all just outside noise. Inside these walls, all we care about is ball. All
right, well, I'm willing to put in the work, on and off the court, so whatever it takes. I actually spoke to Freddie Novak.
You talked to Freddie?
Did I do something wrong by talking to Freddie?
Freddie's a nice guy. I like him. But all this stuff about controlling your own narrative... You a ball player, not a politician.
We put together a very specific game plan for you. You hit these goals, you're in the starting lineup. Simple as that.
Okay, Freddie made it seem like I had to do a bunch of PR stuff just to get my shot with the Stars.
That's flat out wrong. This Shep stuff has nothing, I repeat, nothing to do with your playing time. I want you to focus on your craft, not this PR stuff. Am I clear?
Crystal clear.
Good. I don't need to keep you, but if you ever want to talk, or if Freddie gives you a hard time, whatever, my door is always open.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Akpem.
Othello. Don't mention it. Thank me by putting in the work.
See you, Coach.
See ya.
Sounds good, Jerry. Yeah. I'll link up with you later, man. All right, have a great one.
Yo, you want me to come back?
No, you good.
You sure?
Yeah, I just wanted to talk with you about your meeting with Othello.
To be honest with you, man, I'm a little confused.
Yeah, I thought you might say that.
Yeah. So you know something?
Man, I'm all over it.
So what's your take on it then, man? In one ear, I got Freddie telling me one thing, and the other, I have Othello basically forbidding me to talking to Freddie.
Oh, well, he forbid you?
Well, not exactly, but he's not happy that I'm talking to him. I mean, the thing is, you know, winning over the fans, I'm all for. It is my thing. It's a great idea. It's well-researched. But Rick, man, if it's me stepping on people's toes, I'm not for it. Like, I don't want to make the coaching staff angry.
That's not going to happen, all right?
So what's the plan, man?
Well, first of all, relax. All right, everything's fine, man. It's just a little palace intrigue. That's
all. Palace intrigue? All right, sure.
Look, your president of basketball ops, Phil Boyer, He's feeling the heat right now. He underestimated the PR hit that he would take by drafting you while Shep is still on the board. And optics, for better or worse, are very important for a man in his position.
Yeah, I mean, he's got a career to consider, so I get it.
Okay, so if you take this whole thing seriously, it'll do a great deal of getting you ahead.
Okay. Well, like I said, I'm down for whatever. Just say the word.
All right, that's good. But meanwhile, you still got Othello Akpem thinking that Freddie's some existential threat.
A threat?
Yeah.
Yo, bro, what is he, like, angling for his job? Dude is in marketing, man.
I don't know. Stranger things have happened, man.
Wow. I don't know. Dude seemed pretty straightforward to me.
I mean, that was my read too, but I mean, that don't mean Othello's not worried. Look, the way he sees it, Phil's legacy is tied to you, which means that Freddie's got his ear because you come with a lot of media baggage.
Okay, again, that part makes sense.
Okay, plus you got the whole data-driven angle. You gotta remember, Othello's old school, like a real scouts and chalkboards type. Thinks that anybody with a computer's trying to push him out the league.
Right.
All right, so all I'm saying is you gotta walk a real fine line here, man. I mean, goes without saying, you have to perform.
Yo, the funny thing is, That does not seem to be the focus right now at all.
Like, I mean, you want the money, right?
Hey, hey.
Then this all comes with it.
Hey, I ain't complaining. I just think it's funny, man.
Look, all this means is that we gotta be delicate, all right? So instead of launching this, you know, full-on PR blitz, probably on the lines of what Freddie would want, let's dip our toes in this whole plan to win over the fans.
I think I know what you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
You want to slow play it.
Slow play it, exactly.
All right.
It's not like we won't do nothing. We'll just ease into it. Keep Othella and Freddie happy, which keeps Phil happy.
Okay.
Which makes us one big, happy, slightly dysfunctional family.
Okay, okay, okay. I can, it's all making sense now. So when we start, man?
Well, Mila and Ashley are running point on this, so I'm sure they'll hit you up when they got something to say.
Yo, let them know whenever, wherever, it don't matter. I'm there, I'm your guy.
Okay,
let's get it.
Okay, I get it. Look, in the meantime, you just focus on ball, all right? Hit the goals that Othella and Coach G gave you, win some games maybe, and we're gonna be golden.
Win some games?
I'm just saying.
Hey, that ain't no issue.
Yeah, I didn't think it was gonna be.
All right, then.
All right, get out there, man.
Doing all right.
Go get him.
Quickly passes to Randall. Left side, Robinson. Quickly outside. Let's the three fly. Rebound Detroit. They've got rebound number 5 here tonight. So far, rebounding has been a focal point for them. Oh, got that one up quick. Out MP. What a college career he had. Just fantastic in school. A star on many levels.
MP playing 3 years before coming to the NBA. That is rare these days, but I think it was great for his overall development.
Go down, Brad.
Stewart just relied upon to bring physicality and aggression to the floor, something he does well.
And Stewart is one of those guys that you can count on to provide energy.
No doubt, B.A., he's going to crash the glass. He's going to be ferocious down there. And I like how he focuses on taking higher percentage shots. He may not be the strongest inside presence in the league, but still, he's got to convert from there.
Cash. It's MP picking up the assist.
Number 8.
MP's got 3 assists tonight. Quickly against MP. Quickly passes to Reddish. Randall, a screen on Burks. Reddish misses. Grant, they could attempt a 2-for-1 here.
They could. The key here is a good look.
They set a pick. Back to MP. Unloads. And there's another one for the Pistons.
Boy, I like their energy coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Well, if there were 4 or 5 boxes to check in terms of the game plan tonight, they might have checked 6. I mean, they're doing everything out there.
The way they've gotten after rebounds has been impressive.
Inside. And finished off by Stewart.
So far, they're owning both ends of the floor. We'll see if they can keep this going.
Like tonight, that all the hustle plays have meant so much to this team. Now just sustain some of that energy and keep comfortable.
Here's Randall. And the Knicks miss again. And so it's the Detroit Pistons going in.
15, the Pistons, 27.
We welcome you back to second quarter action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. A chance to catch up on some numbers here. The scoring breakdown for Detroit.
Yeah, their early focus on outside scoring has paid off. They're finding plenty of points from three-point land.
Let's make sure that selfish nerve doesn't get tapped, because right now there's great ball movement. They're setting each other up. Let's see if that maintains.
Cunningham in at the 2.
This might make you feel old, but Derrick Rose won his MVP over a decade ago. The 2011 season, whew, that was something special.
MP outside. Durin with the bucket.
They're really dictating the tempo on both ends of the court. You love it.
Yeah, the other team a bit concerned here. They're trailing, and the lead seems to be growing.
Rose with the bucket. D. Rose in 2011, MVP for his hometown team, the Chicago Bulls.
What a year. Top 10 in scoring and assists. He just won that vote in a landslide. That Bulls team winning 62 games, and it beat up on a loaded Eastern Conference. That was LeBron's first Miami season, and Boston still had the big three. Derrick Rose was getting it done.
And let's send it over to Allie LaForce.
Thanks so much, Brian. Well, the Knicks trying to find their way back to the playoffs. Coach Tom Thibodeau said, you can't look backwards and you can't look too far down the road. You just have to take a look at today, lock into what we have to do, and focus on how we can be better. Back to you.
No shortcuts to greatness, Allie. Thanks for that.
In today's NBA, you have to stretch the floor if you want to win. They have loads of confidence from three-point land right now. And their physical dominance has been on display. A 10-rebound advantage is a good indicator of how this game is going.
That's one of those games for Bagley where he just looks so confident.
Watch outside. Barrett passes to Toppin. Back to Barrett. With the drive. It's good. Barrett's got 10 points.
He's a go-to guy for them because he's that consistent. Time and time again, he delivers.
Pass to Bagley. Back to MP. Bagley, a screen on Rose. Left side Bagley. Shot clock at 6. There's a screen. And here's MP from outside. Connects from downtown. He's got 10.
And you'd think their lead would hold as long as they continue to shoot like this.
Since hiring Tom Thibodeau, every year the Knicks have been at the bottom of the league in pace.
Well, Thibs rhymes with grind, doesn't it, B.A.? I mean, it doesn't really, but it should.
To the inside, Bagley. Oh, the big finish by Bagley.
Well, at
just over a minute and a half played in the third. Here's Rose. And that one hits the back iron.
They really have a commanding lead, not just in points, but in rebounds as well.
And forward, it's Barrett and Randall. Derrick Rose is out there with Jalen Brunson. And it's Robinson in at the center position. That's the 5 for New York right now. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. Jalen Brunson. Granted, it's a shooter's league, and we're seeing more and more big men float out to the perimeter. And
number 8.
The game has evolved, and the shooting, particularly from the bigs, is fantastic. But you know, I wish the bigs had a little bit more diversity. I don't mind shooting from the perimeter, but every once in a while, go mix it up and take advantage of your size mismatch in the paint.
Durin, he's checked in for Bagley. And again, the Knicks missing.
Well, that's not a shot he's ever going to pass up, and he shouldn't. Despite the miss, no defender anywhere near him. He's got to shoot that one.
Pass to Durin. Back to MP. Shot from 16. Second chance shot. Here's Stewart. MP outside. Shot clock at 5. Back to Stewart. Good. And the assist goes to MP. MP's got his 7th assist of the game with that last one. Rose finds Barrett. And now we're 3 minutes into this third quarter of play. Randall, left side.
2 minutes remaining in the third.
To end the drought! And the Knicks miss again.
Not a way to get out of a funk. He needs to be looking for good, solid, more efficient shots. Not the wild one he took there.
I got to help, outside.
Rose against MP. On the wing, Burks. MP, a screen on Barrett. From deep three-point range, and the Pistons!
Throughout this game, finding lots of openings and turning them into big shots.
And I feel like another part of tonight's game has been the hustle. The hustle points, getting up and down, getting second chances, getting transition opportunities. They've been fantastic in that area.
And Detroit, let's look at who they've got. Ivy is the off guard and Bay the small forward. Then it's Duren, then it's MP, and it's Livers in at the power forward position. Barrett with it, now guarded by Bay. Count it. Barrett's got 4 points in the quarter.
Do you think about all the ways that R.J. Barrett is getting that scoring done? Versatile.
Hey, in six attempts, he's made five. Talk about efficiency.
And trust me, when the D's slow to react, he'll be the first guy to make them pay.
Well, I know they don't have mobile devices out there for texting, so they might as well talk to one another.
And Reddish gets it to go.
Quick trigger from Reddish there speaks to his confidence. He just let that one fly.
73.
MP outside. They set the pick. From behind the arc. Another three for Detroit.
This is what it's been since halftime. Remarkable results from downtown.
Yeah, pretty infectious right here. Guys in good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
Pass to Randall. Three-pointer. And Ivy pulls it down.
I know he's on a cold streak, but he can't let that get in his head.
Especially if you're a player that doesn't get a lot of shot attempts, but otherwise, the mindset is, I just got to get the next one to go. And you don't want to put that much pressure on yourself.
He drops it from range. MP's got 9 points here in the second half.
And what a complete performance we saw from them. A dominant win in every way for the Pistons.
A pair of tremendous rebounding teams.
And these guys played a little harder tonight, and that was the edge they needed.
And this one concludes with their second victory of the year.
Yeah, this is far from the last word in the season series. Still three more meetings between them and plenty of motivation to square things up.
And what a huge performance it was for MP.
And with all these assists, it's obvious how well that he can see the entirety of the floor out there. If an easy bucket is to be had, he'll find it.
Here's Rose. Ooh, nothing falling for them right now. And here's Detroit. MP outside. Pass to Livers. Back to MP. Down low. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Showing us that killer instinct right now. No letting the foot off the gas for them.
Yeah, up until that point, a competitive game, but once they broke through that barrier, it was all them, complete control.
So we see the Pistons taking the W here.
A bash? Press?
No. I gotta show you something. Just watch this.
Hey, what's MP stand for anyway? Sounds like a phone to me. I got that MP29, that Nokia joint.
No, I think it stands for mostly pathetic.
No.
Major pose.
Missed the point.
Musty pillow.
Yo, why is that so funny though?
I think it's because she's an agent. Usually they're not funny, they're just suits. But this agent, she's very funny.
Oh, yeah.
She's supposed to be friends with everybody. You know what I mean? That's kind of their deal. Right.
That is my deal. I'm either your friend or your worst enemy, and nothing in between.
You still salty Ricky Bennett didn't join your agency, Barbara?
Oh, come on now. I was just trying to help a brother out. It's not my fault that he doesn't understand the rules of the game.
Oh, Shep, you know, I got a serious question for you. Why can't she be more of a leader like MP? Why are you going to be so gosh darn selfish all the time?
Man, anyone looking up to that bum now? Good luck leading the team when you buried on the bench.
But you know who I really feel sorry for? Like, honestly, his girl. All these NBA players. She's stuck with that clown? I mean, realistically, man. He probably got a whole closet full of cardigans and pleated khakis.
She'll figure it out. Speaking of, yo, Mila, your boy's single. Hit me up if you ever want to see what it's like to be with a real man.
Oh, wow. I am not touching that one.
Look, this episode is going to do numbers, bro.
Was there ever any doubt?
Hey, Shep, any final words you want to say to MP? You know, before the camera dies, because we're making this fire content right now.
Yeah, for sure. I just wanted to say, your game's trash. Your agent's trash. Your girl's trash. And you're trash. Did I forget anything?
Girl, agent. I think you got that covered, buddy.
And the next time I see you, I'm going to tell you that to your face. Other than that, you know, just wishing you many blessings, brother.
Anyway, that's real classy. Why would he even mention me?
Is he Shep? Does he need a reason?
No, he does not.
Clown. Look, this means nothing. It's just some loudmouth being a loudmouth. But you do have that Top Takes Daily interview tomorrow, and they're absolutely going to want to ask about this,
yeah,
given how inflammatory it was. Like I said, it's no big deal. It is no big deal, but we are going to obviously need to strategize your response, okay? So meet me at the business hub after you finished up here, and we'll go over whatever it is we need to go over. Yeah?
Okay. Yeah. I appreciate you, Ash. Always keep me in the loop, no matter how painful it is. Thank you.
It's literally what you pay me to do. But yeah. See you in a bit.